Hello, party people. This is Nikita Lamberti speaking. Welcome to the new game of the day. This one is going to be another Sicilian defense classic. This game was played between Robert James Fishon and Michael Tal in 1961 in Bled. And okay, I mean, those two world champions had a lot of games and duels, but I guess this one is not that highly published, and I think it's a very interesting game. I think it really shows you how to attack some weaknesses if black doesn't play correctly. Okay, let's start. White Fischer played e4. We see the open Sicilian, nothing unusual here. Okay, black plays the early queen to c7. And okay, here white played the not that often played move g3 with the idea of playing bishop to g2. And here black maybe played a little bit too quick. He played his knight to f6. A better move would have been to play a6. Because now, after knight to f6, white can play his d4 knight to b5. And now black has already problems, because he has to retreat. He played, Tal played his queen to b8. And now Fischer played his bishop to f4. So the queen is attacked again, and basically here Tal already lost 2 tempi. Now here Tal played his bishop to his knight to e5. Another move would have been to play e5, but the problem is that after e5, white simply plays his bishop to f6 and captures, and that would have not been, that would have been the problem is that you would open up here the queen side, so black did not want that, and he went to knight to a5, pardon. And here comes a funny move by Fischer. He plays his bishop to e2. He saw that the control of the f3, g4, and h5 squares are more important than putting the bishop on g2. Okay, I mean, here already white has big big advantage. I mean, all of his pieces are developed. Black has no counterplay. And d6 is incredibly weak. I mean, if a piece lands here, then it's basically game over. Okay, that was one. Here, black tried to put his bishop on c5, attacking here the f2 pawn and trying desperately to develop his pieces. And here, Fischer just took on e5. Black took took back. And the idea is white wants to play on d6. As I said, d6 is a weak square, and white tries to attack this this weak square. He plays f4, kicking the queen back, and now he plays e5, all according to the grand strategy. Now d6 is even weaker. Here white now controls d6. And if you can't play d5, then basically you have a big problem. Already the engine gives a big advantage to white. I mean, it's clear why. He's better developed. He controls relevant squares, and black has no counterplay. Black played e6, and white here just took on f6, ignoring the threat. Black took back. He took on b5, taking White's bishop, White's knight, and white here plays now fg7. And this pawn here will cause a lot of problem for black. Tal thought that he could just capture this pawn, but white makes it very, very difficult for black to capture. So now he plays his knight to e4. The idea is again controlling d6 and f6, and this would be a great problem for black. So black played his bishop to e7, controlling or trying to control these squares. Again, if white manages somehow to occupy this square, then the game is basically over. And white plays his queen to d4. He wants to hold this pawn as long as possible. Then castle long, and attacking here on the d5. Black plays his rook to a4. White ignores this and plays knight to f6 check. Black has to take, and now the black queen is on f6. As the white queen is on f6. Black tries to counter attack. You know, he tries to get an attack going here on the c file and on the a file. Basically, he thought, okay, White's king is still in the center. How can I attack? He cannot castle long because then a2 would be hanging. So maybe I get some counterplay here on the squares. But Fischer didn't care. He played. He castled long anyway because he saw that. After rook taking a2, he just plays his king to b1, and the king protects himself. Black cannot help the rook in a meaningful way. So the rook has to go back. And the idea is that he played rook a6, so the idea is that he wants to play e5 and then attacks the queen. So that he finally gets the pawn, because this pawn here is killing black, and he wants to get rid of it as soon as possible. Okay, white ignores the threat of e5 and just captures on b5. And after this here, as I said, black plays e5. Now white has a lot of good moves. He can play the queen to g5 or to h5 and securing his advantage with no problem at all. But Fischer tried to and succeeded in playing a little bit more adventurous. He sacrificed his queen. And after the rook captures on f6, e to f6, now we have the situation that this pawn here cannot be taken. H6 is H7 is threatened. So and the king is basically stuck in the middle, and you have no development at all. And this is completely hopeless for black. He plays queen to c5. He wants to somehow get these pawns and try to get a little bit of material back. And as I said, white just goes along with his plan. He plays bishop to h7, takes the rook, and black now takes all the pawns. He wants to go in this kind of end game. But this is hopeless, because at the end of the day, white has two pawns more, and the strategy is relatively easy for white. He wants to go to the end game as soon as possible, because after the exchange, he has this kind of end game. And even if he loses this pawn, he will win this pawn, And then he will have this passed pawns just go on, just rolling. And this position here is you can resign here. But black tried to carry on. Here they repeated moves to save some time. But now everything is safe. The black queen has no checks here. This pawn will get lost, and then these pawns are rolling. So I just show you the end of the game. It's not very hard to see the technique here. Tal finally resigned. This position is completely hopeless. Okay, let's go back and look at some variations. I think here queen to c7 is a mistake. This was too early. Better move would have been knight to f6 or e6, but this is, or maybe e6, no, but this is just too early. And the definite mistake was playing here knight to f6. Basically, in all variations, you have to secure b5. You cannot allow b5 with a tempo and then another tempo with the attack on the queen. And Fischer here showed convincingly why. Because, okay, let's look at variation after e5. And as I said, you just can play bishop to g5. And let me think, can you play? It would be good to play bishop to e7. But that doesn't work because, as I said, you can exchange. And okay, why can you not play? Okay, you cannot play bishop f6 because of this check here, which is horrible. So you cannot give up the control of the d6 square, so you have to take with the pawn. But okay, then comes knight to d5, and this is over. I mean, this just looks horrible. You don't need any variations here. So okay, after after bishop f4, you have a basically, is this already lost? Wow. I mean, okay, here Fischer played like a computer. Yeah, this is already horrible for black. Black here played bishop to f5. Yeah, and again, Fischer here plays like an engine. There's no defense. This is already losing. I mean, this is really amazing. But this is what happens if you play the Sicilian. You don't have much wiggle room. You really have to know your variations as black, because you can immediately land in a lost pip position. I mean, even Tal couldn't defend it here. This is really lost for black. Okay, let's look at the position where Fischer sacrifices his queen. Okay, let me think. I wanted to look here at this position. I wanted to look at queen to a5. Okay, but white has no problems here. He can simply Well, yeah, okay, he plays b4. You cannot capture the pawn because then you would lose your rook. You cannot give check because a1 is protected. So you have to somehow hover around by its king, but this gets nowhere because everything is protected. Okay, wow. Okay, this is a... Wow. So this doesn't work. And okay, let's look at the sacrifice here. Again, white has many good moves. As I said, he can play queen to g5 or h4. But even the sacrifice is extremely strong. And okay, this is a completely hopeless position. great game by Fischer. And yeah, I mean, if you play the Sicilian, you really have to know your variations if you want to study these lines. But I guess it's fun to play the Sicilian with white against somebody that doesn't know the variations. You get really funny positions out of it. Okay, thank you very much. Bye bye.